Assalamu alaikum and a very good evening to all the parents, students, well-wishers, relatives and participants of Green Valley Education Institutions. CBSC Pernapet welcomes all of you for today evening. Today is actually a continuation of on 15th October, we had conducted and celebrated Dr. late APJ Abdul Kalam Sahab's birth anniversary celebrations in form of forum, that is discussion forum, based on reading every day will lead to a better life for students, exclusively for students, where reading habit, if it is cultivated in students, what are the benefits of it? What is the importance of it? And how the role of teachers and parents play in this reading practice? Exactly, we have seen in our first session. Now, the continuation of second session is taking place right now in front of all of you by our expert teachers of Green Valley Schools. On behalf of Green Valley School Management, Correspondent Ma'am, Chairman Sir, and teachers, students, all welcome all the participants again. And it is over to Ms. Saraswati, Principal of Matriculation, Green Valley Schools. That is Green Valley Matriculation Schools. It is over to you, ma'am. Please start this session.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. I am greeting to all our parents, teachers, our respected chairman, correspondent, ma'am, and my dear teachers and students. I welcome you all to this wonderful webinar. Now, I request Afzal sir to start his slide. Yes, today we are going to learn about the five active words. How to improve the students' reading skill.
Next slide, sir.
Next slide, sir.
The first one is
regular reading routine. So that means we have to make it reading as a routine. So how we are giving breakfast, lunch and dinner for our children's routinely, like that we are have to make our students to read routinely. We have to practice our students to read routinely, regularly. The first point is learning to recognize the word that they already know. So if you start to read an unknown books, for example, we all know our subject books. Our students will read our subject book fluently. They know to recognize the words. They know to read that clearly. But we have to give them another book out of the syllabus book. We have to give them and we have to make them to practice to read them. So if they start to read the new books, they will learn to recognize the words. So because they already know more words, that words are they are start to recognize. That only we learn in the first point, learning to recognize the words that they already know. Next, we are going to the second point, learning to sound out the words, unfamiliar words. That means they have started to read the unfamiliar. That means before they don't know that word, first time they are going to learn the word. So what they will do means they start to syllabify the words because that is an unknown word. They already know few words which are familiar to them. They will start to read that automatically. But when they are starting to read a new book, they start to learn the unfamiliar words. They will start to syllabify the words and they will start to pronounce it. So this will make them to improve their pronunciation skill. Next, the third point. If your child has not yet learned to read, make a daily story routine into their schedule. So if they have not learned to read, means you just make your children to read a story time regularly. You just make it as a half an hour or 1 hour. You please sit with your children and you just make them to read a story. First, you have to practice them. First, in front of your students, you have to read a story and you have to explain to them. Then next day, you have to make your child to read the story. So like that, you have to practice your child to read the story regularly. That only it was explained in the third point. If your child has not learned to read, make a daily story time routine. So you should practice your child to read daily. Next, fourth point. As your child does learn to read on their own, you can continue your daily night story time together. So if your child, if they start to learn by their own, so without your guidance, they are reading by their own means you have to continue daily story together, and you have to make your children have to read a separate story. After you both of them read, you have to share it. What story you already read and what story I have read, we have to share. So what is the main theme of the story? So what is there? What are the tricks it was mentioned in the story? Like that, we have to communicate with each other. When you start to communicate, your knowledge will increase one by one. So this is that first point is going to tell you that establish your regular reading routine. So however you are making the dinner, lunch as well as the breakfast routinely, like that you have to make your children also to read routine. Please share the next slide, sir. Next, the second slide is encourage your child to read on the regular basis. So you have to encourage us. Encouragement makes your child to improve more and more. You have to always motivate your child. Whenever they fell down, you have to motivate. Yes, you can do. You will do. Like that, you have to encourage yourself. Because your encouraging words only will improve your child's knowledge as well as improve your child's skill more and more. So that only we are going to learn in the second slide, that encourage your child to read on a regular basis. The first point is, if your child appears to be uninterested in reading, it may not be because they do not like to read. The source of the problem could simplify be that they do not like to read the books that they have. If you are thinking thus, your child is not uninterested in reading, means you should never think that they don't know to read. Because what is the problem in that? First, you have to analyze your child why they are not showing much interested in reading. Because the problem, what is the problem means, what the book they have, they don't have interest to read that. But you have to analyze your child in which way or in which content your child have more interest. It may be a sports books or it may be a comics or whatever field they have more interest related to that content. You have to provide the books to them. If you are providing the content related to that, they will, their curiosity will increase more. So they will start to learn. If you are giving a book related, if your son or a daughter is like more about cricket, means you have to give a book related to cricket to your son. Then he will start to read because he have more interest on cricket. So his curiosity will increase more and he will start to learn. That same after reading that book, if you start to give his content book, means what they utilize in that same technique, he will utilize in the content also. So like that same, his knowledge will increase one by one and he will get the interest through content also. Next, second point, try exposing your child to many different types of stories. So if they are interested in stories, you should never provide a single story. You should give them different types of story. So some stories it may give a happy ending, some stories it may give a bad ending. You have to make your child, you have to provide them different kinds of stories. When they start to read the different kinds of stories, they will analyze that. Okay, so this story is ending like this. So they can able to improve their analyzing skill and they will improve their reading skills too. Next, the third point, if your child is wildly curious about animals, outer space or construction machines, try providing them with material about those subjects. So if they are curious, if they have more interest on animals or about space or about machines or about playing or about anything cricket like that, in whichever they have more interest, like related to that books you provide them. If you provide that, surely they will start to read. When they start to read through the interesting subject, sure they will, same thing they will utilize in the content also. So surely their reading skill will improve again and again and more and more. Thank you, sir. Please pass on to next slide. Next, the third slide, use reading examples outside of book. Always we should not stuck only inside the book. We have to practice to our children to show more examples outside of the books. They should always, no need to stuck only in the content. Okay, they should see the examples related to the real life examples and the outside of the books. So let's see the first point. Here are few techniques that you can try to encourage your child to improve and utilize their reading skills. So I'm going to share few techniques which you can try to encourage your child to improve their reading skill. The first point, if your child asks to see a movie, ask them to look up the movie times for you. If your children is more curious in watching the movie, So you have to make your child to see the movie. You should never hesitate them. You should never say, okay, you should not see the movie. You should never hesitate them and you should never avoid them. You should tell them, okay, you are interested in watching movie means, yes, you can, you just make your child to watch the movie, which are related to animals, which are related to sports items, which are related to space, which will improve their knowledge. Like that movies you have to put for your children and you have to make your children to watch the movie. If they watch continuously the movie, their fluency will improve. When they start to listen a English movie, there they are started to communicate. So if they listen that, they will improve their language skills, they will improve their fluency and they will learn how to communicate with each other in which are the situations. So everything they can learn through that watching movies. Next, the second point, if your child loves to help you to make a dinner, let them select a recipe from your favorite cookbook and read the steps to you. Okay, if your child, they are saying, yes, I want to help you for cooking. So I want to help you like that. If your child does, please give them a chance and you just tell them, okay, take a cooking book. You just read out the steps. What are the steps we are given and read out the recipes. What are the things I need to add and how I want to make this? You have to read and you have to explain. If you explain, I will do it. If you try to do like that, your students, they will read out and they will try to explain you. So this will improve their language skill more. And then encourage your child to read the road signs, weather reports or emails from other family members. So wherever you are going, you just make your child, whenever you are seeing some more posters or anything, please encourage your child to read that, what is mentioned in there. So when they are seeing the road signs, you please ask your children to read what is mentioned in the road signs and what it tells about. You just ask your children. If you ask your children, they will feel very happy and they will say it and they will try to explain to you. So please, whenever the parents you are going with your children, you please ask them to read the posters or read the road signs, what all mentioned. And when you are listening to the weather reports, please ask your children what is informed about weather, how it possible, what are the things will be there. Everything if you ask means they feel very much interested and they will start to learn more about it. Next slide. Stay involved in your child's reading education. So you should never make your child to read alone. So most of the parents, we are telling that, okay, now it's the reading time. You go and sit alone. You don't want to disturb me. I have to do this much work. I have to cook food or I have to watch movie like that. The parents are telling, but you should sit with your child. When you are sitting with your child, they feel that my mother is watching me. So I have to read. So like that, they feel some more comfortableness. So always please sit with your child when they started to read. So the first point, teacher may not always know when your child first begins to fall behind in their reading skills. So I always used to say that mother is the first teacher and teacher is the second mother. So they both of them has to work together, then only the student and children progress will improve more and more. Because the mother only knows, because she is the first teacher, she only knows that in which thing his children have more interest and when he start, and only the mother knows that, so that apart from teacher, the parents also, you have to take more steps to make your child to read. Don't wait and find that if your children is not reading or if you feel somewhat tough in reading, you have to analyze your child. You have to think why your children can't able to read that. You have to analyze the problem. After you analyzing the problem, you have to try to rectify that. You have to motivate your children and you have to sit and you have to speak with your children. What is the problem you have and what are the steps I will help for you to rectify your problem. Like that, you should feel free to speak with your children. And if you have to make your children to more comfortable with you. If you make that comfortableness with you, your children, whatever doubt you have, you feel very free to, first you will come and ask your parents only. So that you have to make your children to feel free to ask any doubts or if you feel any struggle or anything in their subject, they have to come and ask you. So like that comfortableness you have to give to your children. So you have to analyze the problem and you have to try try to rectify that. So if you can't able to rectify, you have to come with the teacher and you have to discuss with the teacher what the problem your children learn. Surely the teacher will give what are the steps we need to improve the children and we will try to rectify it. So please parents, if you find any struggle with your children, you please come and inform to the teacher and get the solutions and we will improve your children's knowledge more and more. Then at last, take the time to read stories with your child. So always you don't make your child to sit alone to read or don't make your child to sit alone and write. You have to sit with them. If you know or don't know, you have to sit with your child and you have to motivate him and you have to start to read in front of him. If you are reading a storybook, he will start to read the content book. So always the parents, you should play a very good role model for your school, for your children. Whenever they start to read, you please sit with them and you just continue your reading. It may be story books or which are the books you need to read. You please take and sit with your children and you start to read. When you are reading, he also feel that comfortableness. Yes, my parents also is reading. So I have to read more than my parents. Like that, the students will think and they will start to learn more and more. Now the next slide. At last is, remember that every child is different. Yes, every child, he has a unique talent. He has a special talent. We should never think that all children will be same. For example, I'm saying, if we are the teacher, when we are taking the class, totally there are 30 children are there. But 30 children, they have a unique talents. So no one has the same talent. Someone, he has the talent in drawing. Someone is good in reading. Someone good in writing. So each one has the unique talent. So everyone, they will not be same. You should never compare with your child with another. So always your child will be the child. He knows he has some unique talent. We have to analyze that talent and we have to try to improve his talent more and more. We should never discourage our students and we should never compare our children with others. Our children, he has the capacity. We should motivate him and we have to try to improve his skill. We should never demotivate him. So the first point is, the fact that your oldest child could read by age 5 does not mean that your younger child should be expected to do the same. Yes, so most of the parents, we are thinking that, yes, my first child, when he was at the age of 5 itself, you start to write neatly, you start to speak fluently, but my second child, he is not doing like that, because my first child is very brilliant and he is having unique talent, but my second child, he don't have that much talent, how my first child have. You should never underestimate the student or you should never underestimate your children, because each one have a unique talent. If your first son, he has the talent to write neatly and to speak fluently, means your second child, he has a talent to create the letters by his own, to create the words by his own, and he has the talent to create a story by his own. So each one has a unique talent. We should never underestimate any children by our own thoughts. So each one, they have a unique talent. Next, the second point. Above all, remember this, if your child truly does struggle with reading, the best thing that you can do is to support them as they strive to improve. If your child feels embarrassed or ashamed of their difficulties, then they will be less comfortable asking for help. So please remember, all my dear parents, so whenever your child feels struggle in reading, they feel struggle in reading, means you please go and sit with your child and you just ask them what problem they are facing in reading that. So if you feel comfortable, if you make your relationship comfortable only, they will start to say, yes, I feel tough in this reading these sentences. I feel tough in pronouncing the sentence. So they will start to share everything to you. When you find out the problems only, we can able to rectify that. So please parents, sit with your child and just find out the problems with them and you just try to give them solutions. If you can't able to give, you just come and speak with your teachers and they will give the solutions for your children to improve in their knowledge. So, okay, thank you for all who are watching patiently my, what all I'm saying, you are waiting and you are patiently hearing my words. Thank you once again for all of them. And I want to thank my Green Valley Schools, because compare with all other school, our school motto is teach the way children learn. We are always following the same, because how the children, we have to recognize the children talent and we have to improve the skill. So like this only we are analyzing the students' knowledge and we are teaching the way how they are learning. So thank you. So you just share this to your friends and families and you make others to join in our school. Thank you. Thank you once again all. Next, I am going to hand over this to Saranya Miss.
Great, ma'am. It was excellent way, ma'am. I'm really thankful to you. It was an excellent explanation where you have mixed all the things where you are saying that childrens are unique. Definitely all the childrens are unique. Nobody is same. All are talented. Like what you say, like one arrow and two targets. You have said that you have competed in bringing out the talent of the student as well as the reading talent of the student. So according to you, what you said is, yes, if we expose the talent of the student, whatever he is having, definitely he'll be interested in reading the same talent. Example, if a student is excellent in reading, in playing cricket match, if we expose the talent by giving him a sports book, definitely he'll be interested in reading. Once, step by step, we can go with the subjects. It was an excellent way. Thank you, ma'am, for your unique approach of today explaining the importance of reading. Let me go to next speaker of the day. Ms. Sarandya, who is the coordinator of Green Valley's educational institutions. Sarandya, ma'am, it's over to you.
Yes, sir. A very good evening to all the students, parents, well-wishers, and our correspondent, ma'am. A very good evening to all of you. Today, I'm going to talk about read every day, lead a better life. So, this is not only for the students, whoever it might be, if you are a parent or if you are a teacher, or if you are a student, please you can make use of this, then you will definitely lead a very better life. Yes, yeah, so share the screen. So this is our today's topic, read every day, lead a better life. I hope that you are all ready to learn these skills and ideas. Please wait, I'll show you. Reading, we all know that this is the third skill of the language. We have four skills in the language that we all know, that listening, speaking, reading and writing. So it is called a receptive skill, because when we read, we receive language coming in. So that is why they all said that reading is a receptive skill. Yeah, these are the four important language skills. Listening, when you listen, you are getting information, you are learning and you have started to listen the language. So whichever you listen, you will speak. So whatever you listen, you will speak. Then reading. So whichever you read, you will receive everything. You are learning the language. Then whichever you read, you are going to write that. Yeah, for the language learners, you know, for especially the English language learners, it is very, very important. Reading is very, very essential. And I have given some specific reasons why English learners are encouraged to read in English. So these are the specific reasons. The first one is the constant repetition of words and patterns in reading helps you learn and remember vocabulary and grammar structures. Yeah, whenever you read, you learn new vocabulary. So whichever vocabularies you read, whichever vocabularies you learn, you will start using, you will start utilizing this in your conversation. So this is very, very important. Whichever text you read, you are learning something new. So hope for the best and start to learn the new vocabularies and utilize this in your conversation. Then next one is reading helps you become familiar with the rhythm of English. Rhythm is the sound. So once you start reading, you know, you will learn the rhythm of English. Then it will be interesting. So if you want to become a good English reader, you have to read every day. Unlike conversation, reading is something you can do on your own. So when you converse, definitely you might have you will be feeling somewhat excitating. Okay, so reading is rather than conversation, reading is very best way where you can learn on your own. Then reading is not expensive, often free. So reading is not very expensive. It is very free of cost, I think. Whichever you see, you can read. You are learning the information. So if you see any bit of paper at your home also, you are learning, which means you are learning the information. Okay. So that is why I have mentioned here, reading is not expensive. It is often free. Good reading skills can improve your other language skills. You need to learn to read before you can read. So these are good reading skills can improve your other language skills also. If you are a good reader, definitely you will be learning the other language skills also. Reading is the best way to learn and remember the proper spelling of words. So once you start reading, you know, then you will be learning the spellings also. Listening as you read aloud can help you improve your pronunciation skills. This is very, very important. Many of us are lacking in pronunciation skills. So when you start reading, you know, then you will be learning the pronunciation, you will be learning the vocabularies, then you will be learning the rhythm of English. Yeah, if you read every day, you will be learning many information. So if you gain more knowledge, you know, then you will be, definitely you will get success in your life. So the best readers often get the best grades, jobs and opportunities. So if you are a good reader, definitely you will achieve something in your life. Yeah, now I am going to tell you, you will have this confusion, what to read. So I'll tell you what to read. You have to read magazines, you have to read books, then you have to read newspapers. So without spending a penny, you can read anything if you have any books. So apart from your textbook students, apart from your textbook, your subject books, please read whichever materials are available at home. Please start reading any books. Then start reading the magazines, weekly magazines, monthly magazines. Many things are there. Please read. Everything is waiting for you only. You only have to utilize everything. Newspapers, online materials. Now we all of us, you know, nowadays we are all using online materials only. So with that you can also learn many things. Then e-books. So like this you can read anything without spending a penny. Okay. Then there are two important things in deciding what to read. So the first thing, it should interest you. Once you take your take any book or magazine, no, first it should interest you. Then it should not be boring also. So that the reading is fun and not boring. It should be at a level that is not too difficult for you. So if, for example, if you study 10th standard, you should not study your book or the college books. And so you have to somewhat select at the level lower than yours. Okay. So it should not be, it should be at a level that is not too difficult for you. You have to select the books, whichever are there. Then here are some types of reading materials to try. Books, I have told you this already. You can read books, including children's books and newspaper. Students, if you are good at English reading, please start reading the English newspapers. Then it will be very useful for you. Online news articles, online blogs about topics that interest you. Then you can read any letter. Either it will be personal or any commercial letter, whichever letters are available, you can read anything. Then short stories. I think if you read short stories, you know, then it will create a curiosity. Then you will automatically, you will start reading. Okay. Then transcripts. So transcripts of some online videos and subtitles on movies. So if you watch any movies, you know, Tamil movies or your native language movies. So if you watch anything, then the subtitles will be coming. So with the help of that subtitles, you can read. Okay. Then you can read poetries, you can read proverbs, cartoons and jokes, recipes for cooking. So if you are interested in cooking, you can read the recipes also. Then advertisements and brochures. So you can read anything, whichever thing is there, you can read. Just read, 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 that's all. So it is an endless process. Then I am going to give you some reading tips. Read at a level slightly lower than what you understand. So this I have told you already, read at the level slightly lower than what you understand. Then only it will be very easy. Then you will get the curiosity. Okay. If you read a difficult text or if you read any other thing, you know, then it will become bore only. Then the next time you will not read anything. So the first tip is read at a level slightly lower than what you understand. Then choose a time and place to read every day or week. Commit to this reading time as if it were a job. So you have to read on the daily basis. Whenever you get any time, whenever you get a leisure time, please start reading. Read what interests you. This also I have mentioned you already. Read whichever text interests you. Visualize what you are reading. So you have to visualize. For example, if you are reading, okay, if you are reading any short story or if you are reading any poetry or if you are reading any letters, please visualize that. Okay, visualize. Then it will be interesting. Listen and read. Find podcasts on videos that have transcripts and read along silently. You can also read out loud with the recording. So with the subtitles, I have mentioned you already that if you have the subtitles, please read along with that. Relate what you read to your own life. So whichever things you read, you have to relate that with your own life. Yeah, so once your reading task, once you have read everything, once it has completed, so after that, in our school also, right, whenever we completed the portion, whenever we read everything, so what will we do? We'll conduct a test, right? So why do we conduct test? We have to assess ourselves, okay? We have to assess. So here also, if you have read anything, you know, you have to assess yourself. Whether what did you understand from that story, like that. So you have to conduct a test, okay? So reading test. Here are some things that you may be asked to do in a reading test or assignment. So this is the first test. Find the gist or main idea. For example, if you have read any story, you have to find the gist, which means you have to find out the main idea. What's the main idea of this essay? For example, if you read any letter, you know, you have to think over the letter. Yeah, what are they going to convey to us? Like that, you have to find out the main idea. Okay, then write one sentence that explains what the reading is about. So you have to, for example, if you have read any any prose, if you have read any prose, okay, and you have completed. So you have to write, you have to explain that prose in one sentence. Okay, then the next test is summarize. So if you have read any story, you know, you have to summarize it. Describe a few of the two on your own language, you can summarize. Match information. For example, match dialogue to a character. Paraphrase, rewrite the text in your own words. This will be very easy and you can follow this, okay? Paraphrase means it is very simple. If you read any text after reading, please you have to write down on your own words. That is the meaning of paraphrasing. Identify parts of speech. So if you read any text, you know, for example, if you read any newspaper, so you have to find out the parts of speech. What is this? Is it a noun? Is it a verb? Is it a participle? Is it a gerund? So like that, you have to find out the parts of speech. Okay, then you will be well versed in the grammar also. Understood? So compare and contrast. So if you read any text, you know, you have to compare what we have read before and now we have to compare and what is this. So you have to write so many questions. Then identify keywords. So whichever words you feel very difficult or whichever words you feel, hey, these are all the unfamiliar words like that, you have to underline those words. Then later on, after once you finish reading or while reading itself, you have to find out the meanings of those keywords, okay, which means unfamiliar words. Match paragraphs to headings. So if you read any paragraphs, you know, without titles, you can mention your own headings also. You can mention your own titles also. Then write an opinion. So if you read anything now, you can write your opinion. Then write comprehension questions. So you can write your own questions. If you have any stories, you know, if you read any stories, you can prepare some comprehension questions on your own. One second. Yeah, now I am going to tell you an interesting fact on reading. Okay, did you know this? The average reading speed of an educated adult is approximately 15,000 to 18,000 words per hour. If you read 4 hours a day, you are likely to go through 60,000 words daily. So I am telling about the average reading speed only. So if you are well-versed, if you are a good English reader, then you can read. Yeah, one thing I want to convey that within overnight, we can't change anything. Nothing can be changed overnight, okay? So unless you practice, you can't gain anything. So practice makes you perfect. So I hope that you will start reading and you will be leading a very better life. Thank you very much for giving me this opportunity. Now it's handed over to Danish.
Saranya ma'am, it was really an unique way and tremendous, fantastically you have explained the importance of vocabulary, pronunciations, paraphrases, and that upon you have concentrated on LSRW.
Yes.
Where listening skills, reading skills, speaking skills, and writing skills, all are very important for a student to be or communicate in English properly. So it was really excellently done by you. Let us go with now a brilliant minds of students. Green Valley Schools have taken an initiative where reading skills are very important for each and every student in their life. If they improve in reading, what happens is, an example, whatever I am thinking, whatever is there in my thoughts is coming in through my mouth. I'm speaking out. Whatever I'm speaking, I'll be writing down in a paper. So same thing happens with a child when they write the exam. When they write the exam, what happens is, whatever the child is thinking, if the child has not read the book properly, if the child has not read the question properly, he will get confused. If the reading is perfect, if the understanding is perfect by the child, definitely whatever he's thinking will come through his mouth and will come on the paper. So that is the unique way the reading gives an important, if we emphasize on reading, definitely our students or any child will definitely succeed in their examinations. So it is an unique initiative from Green Valley Schools on the day of late Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam Sir Sahab. On his birth anniversary, we have started a revolution that our students should be the best in the reading and LSRW. So right now, let us go to our students. I welcome Danish of 9th standard to take over from here and see the importance of reading according to him. Danish, I welcome you again.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Good evening to all. Hi, this is Danish of 9th standard studying Green Valley Matriculation School, Pernambat. I am very happy to present my slides in front of you. Today we are going to discuss a very important topic, that is reading practice. How can we help the children to become a better readers? Most of us have this doubt. Let's see this. A set of question type will encourage students to reread again. Help your child to become a better readers by asking questions while reading. Let's discuss. For example, when it is a story, you may ask following questions. Who is the main character in the story? What was the problem in the story and how was it solved? How are you like the main character? How are you different? Which part of the story was the most exciting? Why? Which character from the story would you choose to be your friend? Why? Did the character change during the story? How? What do you predict will happen next in the story? These are the questions make children to think about the story again. By this, they will try to read the content again and again. I have 9 simple steps to teach to read at home. Use songs and nursery rhymes to build pronunciation awareness. Make simple cards at home. Play word games at home. Understand the core skills involved in teaching kids to read. Engage your child in a print-rich environment. Harness the power of technology to keep your child engaged. Read together on daily basis and ask questions about the book. Play games to memorize high-frequency sight words every day. Be patient. The best way to teach kids to read is to make it fun. Use songs and nursery rhymes to build pronunciation awareness. When we use nursery rhymes and songs, it will help to build pronunciation skills. Also, a good way to build pronunciation skills is clap rhythmically. Make simple cards at home. Cut out simple cards and write a word containing 3 sounds on each one. Example, ram, sat, pot, top, sun, pot, fin. Play word games at home. Example, start by asking questions like what does the word start with E and end with H. During this time, children will be very excited to think. Understand the core skills involved in teaching kids to read. They are phonemic awareness, phonics, vocabulary, reading, fluency. It's important to remember that learning to read involves various different skills. Engage your child in a print-rich environment. Technology is a thing which is developing day by day. So make sure that children must be engaged with that. Create daily opportunities to build your child's reading skills by creating a print-rich environment at home. Harness the power of technology to keep your child engaged. Sometimes a child might be full of excitement and eagerness to learn at the beginning, but once they hit a wall, can feel overwhelmed and give up easily. To avoid this, we should reward students regularly. Read together on daily basis and ask questions about the book. This creates students to listen the story attentively. Strengthen your child comprehension skills by asking questions while reading. For younger children, encourage them to engage with the pictures. Example, do you see the boat? What color is the cat? For younger children, ask questions about what you just read. Like, what would you think the little bird was afraid, etc. Play games to memorize high-frequency sight words every day. The strategy for learning sight words is see the word, say the word. Learning to identify and read sight words is essential for young children to become fluent readers. Most children will be able to learn a few sight words at the age of 4. Example, is, it, my, me, no, see, and we. You can teach sight words by playing with flashcards. Be patient. The best way to teach kids is to make it fun. Every child learns at his or her own pace. So always remember the single most important thing you can do is to make it enjoyable. Now I will thank you. Now I will hand over to Dania.
Thank you, Danish. It was really an excellent explanation about the phonic sounds, playing games, as well as cultivating reading habit while playing the word games, which is nowadays a trending fashion of word games in the Play Store, as well as you have concentrated on sight words. It is really an excellent explanation from you. So let us go to our next brilliant mind of Green Valley Schools, Dania Khan from 9th Standard.
Good evening to all and assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuhu. I am Dania from Great Green Valley Matriculation School, Pernambat. Today we are going to see an interesting topic, strategies to improve reading skill. First, we should know why do we need reading skill. Developing reading skill is incredibly important for growing readers, starting as early as picture books. As children get older, it will help them understand textbooks, newspapers, and other more complex texts. Let's see the five strategies to improve reading skill. First, have them read aloud. Second, provide books at right level. Third, reread to build fluency. Fourth, talk to the teachers. Fifth, supplement their class reading. Now we will see one by one. First, have them read aloud. Most of the auditory learners used to read aloud, but it is useful for everyone when we pay patience. This forces them to go slower, which gives them more time to process what they read and in turn improves reading comprehension. Plus, they are not only seeing the words, they are hearing them too. You can also take turns reading aloud. Second, provide books at the right level. Make sure your child gets lots of practice reading books that are not too hard. They should recognize at least 90% of the words without any help. Stopping any more often than that to figure out a word makes it tough for kids to focus on the overall meaning of the story. If your child needs help transitioning from picture books to chapter books, try Scholastic's branches books, which are designed to bridge the gap for growing readers. Third, reread to build fluency. It is a very, very important strategy. Rereading will help students to learn the content easily. To gain meaning from text and encourage reading comprehension, your child needs to read quickly and smoothly, a skill known as fluency. By the beginning of third grade, for example, your child should be able to read 90 words a minute. Reading comprehension is the ability to process text and understand its meaning and to integrate with what the reader has already known. Rereading familiar, simple books gives your child practice at decoding words quickly, so they will become more fluent in their reading comprehension. Fourth, talk to the teachers. It is also an important strategy. When you need to talk with teacher about problems, a calm and positive approach is likely to get positive outcome, and we should be keep touching with the teacher. If your child is struggling with reading comprehension, they may need more help with building their vocabulary or practicing phonics skills. This PT, the CAT phonics box set, and this PAW Patrol phonics box set are fun ways to help your child build necessary phonics skills. A teacher can weigh in on the best next step to take. Fifth, supplement their class reading. Nowadays, parents are very busy with their business or jobs. Everyone should realize your child's future. But when you don't read the children, then it will be difficult to expect better future. If your child is struggling a particular theme, look for easy to read books or magazines on the topic. Some prior knowledge will help them make their way through tougher classroom text and promote reading comprehension. Thank you to all the parents, teachers, students, and friends for giving me your precious time. And thank you to the Green Valley team for giving me this opportunity. Thank you very much. Now I am handovering to Azhan of grade 9th.
It was really, what to say, fantastic, Dania, because you have given emphasizing on reading skills, importance of reading different kind of books. scholastic activities or books, especially you have concentrated on fluency. Fluency is what very important nowadays. Few students are there who might score very good marks, who have a very good handwriting, but they are not good coming to spoken English. Why? Because they are very less in reading. So what you have emphasized on fluency and expectations of parents. Yes, expectations of parents are very high for our schools, but I request our parents also to please give some time for your child, emphasize on reading. No doubt how parents are important. Teachers are also important as well as responsible for the reading practice of children. Now, let us go to our last speaker of the day, one of the brilliant minds and unique boy of Green Valley Schools. It is over to you, Azhan, from 9th standard.
Yes, sir. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh and very good evening to all. Hi, this is Pallu Mira Muhammad Azhan, studying 9th standard in Green Valley Matriculation School, Pernabat. As Danish and Danya's points, we have to concentrate on reading practice and strategy to improve the reading skills. Now we are going to discuss the most important topic, reading. Totally, we have 6 reasons to improve your child's reading. Is everything is possible? Yes, everything is possible, but we want to try. Let's see. Attention let you know. Children know that you love them. Love helps your child mental well-being. Love makes your child physical healthier. Love increases your child brain development and memories. Love creates a stronger bond between parent and child. So listen here carefully. In all the places, affection plays an important role. Reading will encourage them to become a good reader. How you want to focus on them? There are ways to focus on them. Think carefully about their reading. Make sure the words look right. Make sure the words sound right. Use their schema. Ask question. Read with expression. Check to see if it makes sense. It can see you're really thinking. Keep on trying. You almost got it. I can see you tried hard. I appreciate your help. How do you feel about that? I am glad you enjoy learning. I'll bet you that you could do it. It is fun for both children and adults, as many books have hidden surprise and puzzles. Most children like to fun with parents. If the parents try, definitely they can see their hidden talent of their child. Better behavior. Kind kids develop better behavior skills and show improved behavior when their parents are involved at school. Improved education. Research shows that parents' involvement can help improve the quality of school, raise teacher morale, and improve a school's reputation in the community. Reading helps them become lifelong learners. The information and illustration are entertaining as well as educational, giving children a love of learning. Reading helps to go all over the world. Is it possible? How it is possible? When we have good reading skill, we don't need to bother. Reading encourages your child's imagination to soar. Yes, it is unbelievable, but we should believe. Imagination, allowing a child its mind to wander into the realms of fantasy, enhances the process of development. Here is the place where parents who concentrate, read and share stories with their child gain immense importance. Learning, remembering and believing. Parents are their first teacher and they have a key role in shaping up their character. A balance of education at home and school molds and students' actual learning. Parental encouragement had played a crucial role in successful school. Their role is not limited to home but in involvement is school activities. If your child wants to learn, you should learn before them. Do not forget to guide them. Believing is very, very important. Thank you for giving me this great opportunity to my team and teachers and staff. Thank you. Assalamu alaikum.
Thank you, Azan. You have concentrated on development of a child through the involvement of parent. Motivation is very, very important for parents. And moreover, you have emphasized on saying that all the children are unique. So we request all the parents, never compare your child with anyone. Please never compare. Whether he's scoring marks, whether he's scoring more marks, whether he's scoring less marks, definitely he will succeed one day. He have that talent. That unique talent is present in each and every child. Let us motivate them. Let us make them read. Let us make the change. Let us start the revolution of reading from Green Valley. So I request all the parents, please give your 15 minutes of time, not more. Give your 15 minutes of time. Make your child read the book which he is interested in. Please don't force the child to read what you want. Please make the child read what he or she wants. Whether if he is interested in sports, whether she is interested in English or other subjects, please let them read. For 15 minutes, even if there are mistakes, please motivate them. Identify the mistakes and please say them. Yeah, you're reading excellently, but this is not the word what you're reading. Let me correct this. The way of expressing, the way of attitude you show to your child is lays the foundation for children's. Today's foundation will bring tomorrow success stories for each and every student. So Green Valley schools are taking a lot of initiative with reading skills from now onwards. We need compulsory reading. I request all the parents to make your child read, and please send a WhatsApp to us that how much minutes your child has spent with you for reading. Every week from LKG to 9th standard metric, LKG to 6th standard CBSE, every week we request you to send every Saturday your feedback of your child in reading the books. Whether let it be the English, Tamil or any other language, but they have to read. They have to read. Make sure they will read and they will succeed. Definitely we are here to motivate our students. We will definitely appreciate our student by making their photos and parents' photos uploaded in our Facebook as well as YouTube. So I request parents, please start this initiative from you. Please make your child to read at least 15 minutes every day from today. From 1 week, definitely you will see most possible changes in the child. That is a challenge from Green Valley. Please get involved with our teachers. Yes, we are here to make your child successful. Now, it's over to Malti ma'am for vote of thanks. Our coordinator of Green Valley Schools. Malti ma'am, it's over to you.
Yes, sir. A very good evening to all. I am here to spell out words of thanks to all those who made this evening a sweet memory to carry home. It gives me an immense pleasure to deliver the vote of thanks for this event to all dignitaries assembled here. I would like to thank our chairman, sir, correspondent, ma'am, academic head, teachers, and students for making webinar a successful. Thank you all.
And moreover, I really, really appreciate the way our students have come up in the webinar, and mostly, and I really appreciate the three teachers who have made this successful. That is Mr. Rajiv, who is not here because of his health issues. He is the main coordinator of this program. I thank Rajiv, Mr. Rajiv, sir, Ms. Saraswati, ma'am, that is principal ma'am, and Mrs. Saranya, who have taken a lot of hard work to make this event successful, and all the teachers, especially our computer operator, that is DTP operator, Mr. Abzal. I am really thankful this idea from our correspondent ma'am. I'm really thankful to ma'am because this initiative from today will definitely bring revolution in reading in our students. Thank you all.